chapters wherein drug dependency and psychotropic drugs, some definitions you need to remember. And again, these are most frequently asked in Viva, and even you can expect those as a one-mark question. First and foremost is the word drug, and drug means any chemical entity or a mixture or other than that are required for maintenance of normal health. When given, it alters the biological function and the structure of the body. And coming to the word drug abuse, it means that a persistent, sporadic, excessive usage of drug inconsistent with or unrelated to acceptable medical practice. Example, abusal of opium, barbiturates, and unsanctioned use, hazardous use, dysfunctional use, or harmful use, wherein if it has been used over the dosage limit, then it can relates into these side effects on a individual. The word drug addiction, it is a state of periodic or chronic intoxication due to repeated consumption of a drug which is harmful to the individual as well as the society. And examples like heroin, alcohol, cannabis, opiates, and other. The definition you need to remember is drug habituation, and it is resulting from continuous consumption of a drug but not much harmful to the individual or the society. Like examples are caffeine and nicotine. And coming to this, another term you need to remember is polysubstance dependence. It means that this period or this term is reserved for a behavior during a period of 12-month period in which the person repeatedly use at least three groups of substances, not including caffeine and nicotine, but he uses some three groups of substances. And out of all three, no one has been single substance, it has not been used predominantly. Then the state of the individual and the period is 12 months and a group of three drugs, at least three groups of drug to be used, and not even one being predominantly used. And even then, it satisfies the definition polysubstances dependence. And further, during this period, the dependency criteria were met for the substances as a group, but not for any specific substance in isolation. Moonukume, he is totally dependent, and predominant unukumato dependent illa, or specific substance kumato dependent illa. Other exclusion is, it doesn't include caffeine and nicotine. Defined as a chronic disorder characterized by compulsive use of drug, intense craving is seen, and in terms and which results in physical, psychological, and social harm, and continuous use despite the evidence of that harm is well known to the individual. Like alcohol, tobacco are the most commonest substances for abuse, followed by sedatives, tranquilizers, cannabis, opiates, and cocaine are other examples for addiction, and followed by amphetamines, hallucinogens are less popular in forms of addictions. And this so wherein at any scene of crime can able to make out unused or used syringe which needle and some ligature like material, and these are being tied to make the to make a prominence over the peripheral vessels, and followed by these have been injected, and the most preferred site will be over the cubital fossa. And for example, if an individual being predominant side is right side, most commonly can able to make multiple injection prick marks over left cubital fossa. And to disclose this area, the individuals, the chronic addicts, may bear a tattoo mark over to hide all those injection prick marks. And coming to this differentiation between addiction and habituation, and same a table column that has been given in your textbook, and all these five headings are highly important to differentiate this addiction from habituation. And it starts with the letter C, compulsion. Addiction, it is present compulsorily. The individual need is badly in need of the substance. Habituation, there is a desire to consume, but there is no any strict compulsion. And regarding the dose, in addiction, it tend to increase. In habituation, it remains the same, right? And followed by in dependency, it could be of psychological and as well as physical. And here, some degree of psychological dependency is seen, but there is no any physical dependency. And regarding withdrawal symptoms, characteristic symptoms are being seen. And here, it is none or very mild. And coming to harm, it is harmful for the individual as well as the society. And how the society been affected? If a drug is not been available, these individuals will be turning violent, and they can attack the bystander, or otherwise they don't have a money to buy those. They can also become indulge in theft, and in course of event they may even turn violent, and even death could result in to steal money from others. And in case of habituation, in any, it is primarily to only the individual but not to the society. And here examples like heroin, alcohol, cannabis, opium, opiates and cocaine, LSD, ash, and followed by barbiturates, madrugs are the substances towards addiction. At least if you remember, heroin, alcohol and cannabis more than sufficient. And here the caffeine and nicotine are the most common substance. And even if you ignore nicotine, caffeine is a substance wherein most of the people are habituated to it, right? Drinking a coffee early morning, we tend to drink a coffee, right? And here there is no tendency to increase. It means that every day you will drink only a cup of coffee, right? And even if you miss the coffee, you may suffer from mild withdrawal symptoms like mild headache, and you may be tense. And for a coffee is not been available, you don't indulge in any antisocial activity, hope I guess. And there is only a desire, but there is no any compulsion. Even when coffee is not available, people tend to adjust to it. And but when these substances are not available, the individual turn violent, then they indulge in antisocial activities. And coming to causes of drug abuses, and again, nothing to discuss, right? And you are more familiar with all these situations wherein we come across all papers and other, and for a drug abuse wherein sports for the better performance, recreational or period of relaxation from the stressful life, control of anger, distress, tension, and any failure or recent frustration in love, sex and life. Out of curiosity, it means that the individual want to try it, what will happen if it has been taken. And due to hearing the experience from other persons and other, we try those. And these are the causes for drug abusal. And followed by, again, drug abusal may be also aphrodisiac, wherein people think of it tends to increase the potency and other. And when you come to doping in sports, wherein World Anti-Doping Agency is strictly monitoring, especially during the times of Olympic, you would have come across on a paper wherein displaced expose themselves to ingestion of drugs and other medications wherein those are being listed as doping or the substances should not be consumed prior to the any sport event, and like hormonal and any of the substance abusers which have been list marked, which have been blacklisted, and where these players consume those prior to indulging in sport activity. And here for an analysis purpose, they take samples for the persons, like samples like urine, hair, blood, breath, sweat, and the oral fluids and saliva will be tested for either the presence or absence of the specified parent drugs or their metabolites. And there have been many incidents wherein players have been announced as a gold medalist and other, and after which the test found to be positive, then their medals and other have been taken back by the organizing committees. And here, not that of an importance, just read once, twice. And here you need to remember the word hard drugs, soft drugs, and rest others, your basic pharmacological classification, if you remember, then it is more than sufficient, and you need not break your heads to remember the other thing given in a forensic textbook. To the roots, oral is one of the root, followed by inhalation and snorting, and even injection, and or the skin popping is of subcutaneous, main lining is or shooting is of through IV, and fatality of drugs due to overdosage, it results in kick or a rush, and followed by due to contaminants that have been present, like talc or quinine has been added to those substances to increase the amount of the substances, and while this talc and quinine are of a less cost, and they have been mixed as a contaminants to this drugs and other, and taking these substances, it can result in pulmonary granulomas at a later stages. And third fatality or otherwise third complications can occur as a result of drug abuse, especially of IV route. And here, sharing a needle with another drug abuser or etc., wherein it can result in hepatitis B, HIV, abscesses of more of bacterial and other infections are more likely. And fourth, gangrene of blood vessels, wherein this gangrene sits in, and they may block the peripheral circulation. And other points, like it can also cause anaphylactic reactions on sensitive individuals. And diagnosis, based on the presentation of the patient, followed by the signs and symptoms by which these can be detected at early. And coming to this drug dependency, wherein a small letters, multiple paras, and it almost covers a page in your textbook, and it has been simplified. And even if it is, this one is not comfortable, let me know, and I can make in a tableau column, and I can share the same in Google Classroom. And here there are some five types of dependency has been discussed. And first and foremost, it is of morphine type, and second is barbiturate type, and the third is cocaine type. And these are most commonly repeated terminologies under those paras, wherein CAVIC or the dependency is increased in case of morphine type of dependency. And as a result, it also tend to increase the dosage, and due to tolerance effect, right? Due to tolerance, for example, he consumes 5 grams of something, and after which he doesn't feel that he has got enough kick and other, so So we tend to keep on increases the dose, and wherein the tolerance level again increases, and again he go back to the increasing of dosage, and followed by cross tolerance and other can occur in. And if a substance is not available, then there will be more amount of withdrawal symptoms. And in a para, they would have mentioned it as withdrawal symptoms. In other para, almost the same meaning is abstinence syndrome, they would have given, and it almost equivocal or it carries the same meaning. And these are the words given. One is carving, followed by the dose, whether it is increased or decreased, that has been given, and followed by the word tolerance, followed by withdrawal signs and symptoms. And in barbiturate type of dependency, wherein all above are seen, all above are also seen, and followed by, if you make out this, if you read these headings in your textbook, they have given some examples to remember. For example, in case of morphine type, they are given morphine as a substance, followed by pethidine, heroin, and other have been given. And barbiturates, the derivatives of barbiturates have been given. And in case of cocaine type of drug dependency, there is no tolerance. There is no withdrawal signs and symptoms. There is only a pure dependencies seen, and which is something different from other types of dependencies. And when you come to other types of dependencies, other two are cannabis type and followed by amphetamine type of dependency. And in case of cannabis type, there is no increase in dosage, no tolerance, only psychic dependency is seen, and there is no any withdrawal signs and symptoms. Most of the things like dosage, no tolerance, no withdrawal signs and symptoms, there is only a psychic dependency. There is no any physical dependency is not seen in case of cannabis type. And when you come to this amphetamine type of dependency, and as I said earlier, right, the word withdrawal is almost equivocal to the word abstinence. And here there is no any withdrawal signs and symptoms, and there is only psychic dependency, and the rest other are almost similar to barbiturate type of dependency. It means that only four commonly words they have been used in, and followed by they have explained some drugs as an example, followed by some withdrawal signs and symptoms. And just making a tabular column, and even if it is not comfortable, as I said earlier, you will receive a tabular column in your Google Classroom, and you can remember these components alone. And the rest other like signs and symptoms and other are more towards central nervous system, and tremors and other are being given, and you can fill the rest, and more likely to be asked as a Viva question, wherein they use this word, name a drug dependency where there is no effect of tolerance, there is no psychic dependency, name some dependency where there is only psychic dependency, there is no any physical dependency seen, like that they may ask you. And just for an Aviva purpose, you need to remember this description. And when you come to the signs and symptoms discussed under this dependency, wherein these are the commonest signs and symptoms that have been discussed, like loss of appetite and weight, unsteady gait, red puffy eyes, slurring of speech, tremors, impaired memory and concentration are the most common signs and symptoms that have been discussed. And here, loss of appetite, again, individual is more carving towards these drugs and other, so he will not look care of his personal hygiene, nutrition and care won't be taken. So obviously there is no any desire to eat, and if there is no desire to eat, then there will be a definitely loss of weight, and individual being in state of intoxication obviously can't walk, so there is unsteady gait, slurring of speech, tremors, right? There being involvement of central nervous system, and wherein nerves goes for degeneration and other, and due to effects of the drugs that have been consumed, it results in and impairment of memory and concentration, again due to features like hallucination and agitation, restlessness. Again, the individual is not oriented to the current scenario. He lives in somewhere in a imaginary state, so he can't focus to the task that he has been involved in. And when you come to withdrawal symptoms, again, if you can make out under each heading, it is well and good. Or else, if it find difficult, just take a screenshot of this withdrawal symptoms, and you can copy the same for all other withdrawal symptoms where and where it has been discussed in. And the word withdrawal, it same as abstinence. Abstinence signs and symptoms, withdrawal signs and symptoms are almost same. And coming to the word treatment or definitive management, guidance followed by gradual withdrawal of drugs, just almost like tapering the dosage of drugs, decreasing the usage of drugs, and keep a watch on a patient. It means like just like in a babysitting, like in a guide who sits near to the drug abuser, wherein care and affection to be given by the caregivers, parents and other, and followed by we need to keep on watch on the patient. It means that due to non-availability of these and drugs and other, he may commit some threats of suicidal and even para-suicide, or he can manifest as in, and group and psychotherapy, consulting and a psychologist, and followed by institutional therapy. It means that none of the measures that have been carried at home or as in a part of an OP therapy is not successful, then individual can be admitted in a hospital, followed by a therapy is being given, occasional courses, and improving his health by providing adequate food and nutrition, value-rich food can be provided.